हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम अजय प्रकाश तिवारी, वेलकमिंग यू टू ऑल टू वंस अगेन टू माय ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल बायोलॉजी एट योर फिंगर्स। एंड टुडे वी ऑल सेट टू स्टार्ट विद योर न्यू टॉपिक, दैट इज इम्प्लांटेशन। अप टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट गैमेटोजेनेसिस एज वेल एज अबाउट द फर्टिलाइजेशन एज वेल एज अबाउट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द ब्लास्टोसिस्ट और ब्लास्टुला। So today now I'm going to set to start with a new topic, that is simply what implantation. So already I have mentioned here actually what is implantation. So we can write here implantation means that attachment of embryo, or embryo we can say that blastula, attachment of embryo or blastula in the endometrium of the uterus. So actually what is implantation? Implantation simply means that attachment of embryo, or we can say that blastula. We can discuss here also simply attachment of embryo blastula in the endometrium of the uterus. Blastula ka endometrium lining se attach ho jana hi implantation ka process kehlata hai. So this was all about the definition of the word implantation. So implantation nothing is here, simply attachment of the blastula. We can say that attachment of the embryo into the endometrial lining. And this was simply begins in the first week and completed in second week of fertilization. यानी implantation का जो process होता है वो first week जो fertilization का होता है उससे start होके और अंत में जाके second week में खत्म हो जाता है. And the most probable thing is here that attachment of blastula actually takes place on the sixth day after fertilization. It means that blastula got attached into the endometrial lining of the uterus on the sixth day. In certain books it is also written as the seventh day. So in between the sixth and seventh day, I have written the most appropriate answer here, that is what, on the sixth day. And now this was all about the implantation. Now we will discuss the mechanism, actually how it takes place. So mechanism of implantation. In the mechanism of implantation, actually there are certain kind of cell reactions those takes place, and due to all those cell reactions certain kind of changes that appear into the endometrial lining, or we can say that into the body of female. So we all set to study those one by one. So the first one is formation of, this line is very very important, formation of local edema. Formation of local edema. Actually, what is local edema? Local edema means that a particular kind of swelling, or we can say that a swollen part that appear in a particular region into the endometrium. We will discuss here. Let's suppose this was the endometrium, and as you know, this was the blastula, and these were the trophoblast or trophoectoderm. I have already made this diagram in the previous lecture. I am just repeating once again. And here are the cells of the embryonal nerve. So let's quickly recap. This was the trophoblast, or we can also name it as trophoectoderm. This was the blastocoel, a fluid filled cavity, and this was embryonal nerve. Embryonal nerve. And in a particular region, the region in the embryonal nerve, here in the endometrium, there will be appearance of local edema. It means that there will be certain kind of changes in this endometrial lining only in this region. So because changes takes place in this region, that's why this is local, and swelling takes place, that is what edema. So this is what local edema takes place. And now what will be the second point? And in that permeability of endometrium, permeability of endometrium and blood vessels increases. As you know that in the endometrium there are blood vessels, and the permeability of those blood vessels as well as endometrium got increases due to the formation of local edema. So we have discussed that the first, that was very very important, that formation of local edema, and the second is here that permeability of endometrium and blood vessels increases. This is also very very important line. Endometrium disrupted. Endometrium disrupted. Why endometrium disrupted? Because here there will be formation of chorionic villi, and that chorionic villi, let's quickly form that chorionic villi. So this was the cells of the trophoblast or trophoectoderm, and here there will be formation of chorionic villi that will increase in the size, and they will penetrate, and in the last these chorionic villi will reach to the blood vessels or will reach to the maternal blood. So that's why actually here chorionic villi is just penetrating the endometrial lining, that's why endometrial disrupted. And the fourth point here, formation of chorionic villi. And actually these structures are known as what? Chorionic villi. So here formation of chorionic villi takes place, and it's penetrate till it reaches to the maternal blood. It's penetrate to reach in the maternal blood. इसने क्या किया? Penetrate किया, और penetration तब तक किया जब तक ये पहुंच नहीं गई कहां? Maternal blood तक. तो ये कुछ important points थे. एक दो. And now in the fifth step, endometrium covers whole blastula and actually endometrium covers whole blastula and represents, we can say that, and represents interstitial plantation. Implantation. Actually, in the case of human being, and in the case of apes, actually in the case of human being and as well as in the case of apes, the type of implantation is what? Interstitial. So I have mentioned here endometrium covers whole blastula and represents interstitial implantation. Actually, what will be the mechanism? This was the endometrium. Now this endometrium will covers whole structure, and this type of implantation is known as interstitial implantation. And now in the last, let's quickly recap. Actually, chorionic villi will form fetal part of placenta. Chorionic villi will form fetal part of placenta, and the tissues here will form maternal part of placenta. So as you know that placenta is the structure or connection that will provide the nutrient or the nourishment. So let's quickly recap about the implantation. Implantation simply means that attachment of the embryo or blastula into the endometrial lining of the uterus, and this started in the first week of the after fertilization and completed in the second week of fertilization. And attachment of blastula simply takes place on average on the 6th or we can say that 7th day after fertilization. Actually, there are certain kind of changes that takes place during implantation. Out of those, the first was the formation of the local edema. The second one was simply, I have mentioned here, permeability of endometrium and blood vessels increases. The third one is endometrial disrupted because chorionic villi that form from the trophoblast or trophoectoderm, they will start the penetration into the maternal blood. So due to that, endometrium will be disrupted, formation of chorionic villi, and its penetrate to reach into the maternal blood. Jaise hi chorionic villi banegi, wo penetrate karna start karegi, maternal blood tak pahunchne ki koshish karegi. Iske baad in the last kya hoga, endometrium pure blastocyst ko kya karegi, cover kar legi. To ye chota sa concept tha implantation ka. Iske baad इम्प्लांटेशन के बाद फिर आपका एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट स्टार्ट होगा. एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट में हम डिस्कस करेंगे फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑल थ्री जर्म लेयर्स, दैट इज व्हाट एक्टोडर्म, मेसोडर्म एंड एंडोडर्म इन द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज व्हाट गैस्ट्रुलेशन. एंड सिंपली दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट फॉर टूडे. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट, एनी क्वेरीज, यू कैन लीव इन द कमेंट बॉक्स. एंड इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो, प्रेस लाइक बटन, एंड यू कैन शेयर दिस वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स. And as soon as possible, subscribe the channel for latest update of class 12th, as well as in the future I am also going to start the videos of class 10th as well as class 11th. Thank you. That's all about for today. Jai Hind. Keep smiling. Have a nice day.